Hi everyone, I'm Francesco. I'm a PhD student in the University of Florence, and today I present the project that I have done during my junior fellow exchange program in collaboration with the Vita Lab in EFL University. The title of my work is Transfigure Semantic Multimodal Transformer for Pedestrian Action Precasting. Okay, perfect. And my topic is on the autonomous driving. It's not related with media, but is a fundamental technology for the human life, and the attention focus is increasing in these last years. And in the autonomous driving, forecasting the future motion of the pedestrian around you allow to configure the best maneuver of the self-driving car to avoid collision and dangerous situation, reaching the necessary level of safety. But there are several cases that are very difficult to understand, such as stop and go behaviors, where the pedestrian abrupt change is dynamic with respect to its behavior in the past. So is very important to understand this type of the behavior, and the decision depends not only on the past movement of the agent, but also of the characteristics of the surrounding scenarios. To solve this problem, we have developed an architecture, Transfigure, that exploits cross-modality tension between some information like the vehicle, the pedestrian feature, and the surround context. Because given the seen information and at the current time step and the past temporal referring to the pedestrian and vehicles, this model can predict the stop and go behavior, and also the cross behavior can that may occur in the future. And to do this, we use a semantic segmentation map of the current input frames rather than the full temporal visual stream. So, Transfigure is a transformer-based model, and given a set of multimodal inputs can generate the probability of crossing or changing state of the pedestrians. So, first of all, we can describe the type of data that we have. So, we have a static information at the current time, such as RGB frame, pedestrian body box, and some high-level attributes for the sim. For example, if there is the zebra crossing, or if there is a light. Then we have also the temporal information up to present time, such as the pedestrian motion and the vehicle speed. Next, we use a semantic segmentation model to convert the RGB frame into a semantic segmentation, because the semantic segmentation capture high-level content with respect than the simple RGB. Then we use a CNN to generate the figure map of the asymptotic segmentation, and we use also a self-action model, such as a classical transform encoder, to correlate spatial feature among them. Then we can encode the different data, and the data are processed by a separate learnable module. And the type of module depends on the nature of the data. So the sequential input are analyzed by reference networks like a simple GRU, or we use also an LSTM. And the data is channelized by multi-layer perception network. We use also the Roy-Halline module to extract the representation of the pedestrians to understand where the pedestrian is with respect to the frame. And next, each feature is provided as a queries to the cross-action module in a transform decoder. And we also the frame tokens processed by the self-attention model as context. And finally, these multimodal features are fed to the output encoder. And along the input tokens, we feed also a framework classification token. And it's important because it weights the importance of each feature and in the end generates the outputs. So the experiments were performed using two benchmarks, one dedicated to the stop and go benchmark and the second on the crossing benchmark. And we use different dataset dedicated for this problem. Each dataset has our peculiarities and characteristics. And for the segmentation module, we use a state of the art segmentation like mask to format that is presented on Mapillary Vistas dataset. So now we can see some results. From in the table, we can see the performance of this model in the stop and go task, and we can see that this model has a good result with respect to the other model in the literature, and also in the crossing task we have a good results. So different correlation study related to the stop and go benchmark were carried out, and in this table we analyzed what happened if we remove one feature at a time and train and test the model again. And we can see that each feature is relevant to perform the best results. In this case, we can see that if we remove the Roy-Halline system, we have a bad results. Or if we don't use the particular modalities that we observe and we analyze the feature, we have the results drops. Like in example, we each feature is con are concatenate and is processed like a single query to the cross session model, and we can see that the performance drops. In this case, we don't use the self-attention model and the cross-action module, but simply we concatenate all the features generated by the dedicated modules. In this case, we use instead to use a decoder transform, use a encoder transform, and we concatenate all the features together, and we have a bad results. In this case we demonstrate that our model works also we use only the version, so we use only the frame and the bounding box of the pedestrians. In this case, now we can analyze the importance to have a good semantic segmentation because further experiments were carried out taking the other segmentation module like DeepLab EV3, and as we can see from table, the segmentation generated by DeepLab lead towards performance and use a better segmentation if we use transformer. And this means that the quality of the segmentation is crucial, as we can also see from the example next to. Now we can observe a positive example, and in this case we have a Go example. So in the past the pedestrian is still, and in the future the pedestrian will move, and we can show the attention between the queries feature and talks of the semantic segmentation, and between the query feature themselves in the cross action module. Finally, we show feature importance by observing the attention that is computed inside the output encoder. And it is very interesting that the model focuses on the pedestrian crossing area and also on the car that is moving away. And in conclusion, transfeature is a pedestrian behavior predictor that is based on multimodal action mechanism, and we can train this model end-to-end because we don't need to fine-tune the model, the segmentation model, and we can use a simple CNN to analyze the semantic segmentation, and we can analyze the context as a single current frame instead of a sequence of past frame. And in the end, we have also the explainability skills because the multi-attention mechanism, we can see the decision the model do when we read in the mechanism. Thanks for your attention.